Hello students, I hope all of you are doing good. Let us study past tense today. Yesterday we discussed present tense and all the four forms of the tense, present tense. Today we'll discuss the four forms of the past tense. Let us start with the simple past tense. As you can see here, the simple past tense is used. The simple past tense is used to indicate actions in the past. Okay, it is used to indicate actions in the past. For example, we have given an example here which says I saw a rainbow. This action happened in the past. Okay, so this tense is also used in storytelling. Okay, this tense is used in storytelling, and also this tense is used to indicate unlikely wishes. For example, here a wish is given here, I wish I knew the answer. And also it is used with if clause. Okay, the example used is I would leave the class if I were. Okay, I were, simple past is used. If I were you, if I were you, I would leave the class. It's a sentence used with if clause. Okay, the form that is used here is second form of the verb, that is the simple past. Okay, the simple past verb is used, the second form of the verb. Okay, there are four forms of the verb we have already studied. The second form of the verb is used with the subject. And in negative sentence that have not or do not, the negative sentence, with the negative sentence, the first form of the verb is used, that the verb is changed, the form of the verb is changed. Okay, okay. And in the interrogative sentence, in the interrogative sentence, did or did not come in the beginning. Okay, they occur in the beginning. Okay, let's continue. Here is a table which shows the simple past. Here we can see, okay, here we can see three forms of the sentence: the simple sentence, the negative sentence, and also the interrogative sentence. In the first simple sentence, only the first form of the second form of the verb is used, that is the past verb. See here, we saw, I saw, you sang, he, it, she, it sang, and they sang. Okay, but when it comes to the negative and the interrogative, which uses not, for example, you can see here the verb is changed to the first form, simple present verb. Okay, see, the verb is not saw anymore, the verb is see. Okay, similarly it happens with all the rest of the verbs. Okay, let's continue with the past continuous. The second form of the past tense is continuous tense. Okay, and it is used for actions. It is used to talk about actions that were going on at a certain moment in the past. Okay, it occurred for a certain time in the past. Okay, for example, we were studying. Okay, in the past they were studying. Okay, to express, secondly, it is used to express continuous action interrupted by another action. If some action happens in between another action in the past, okay, I was passing through the market when the accident took place. Okay, it's an example. I was passing through the market and suddenly, when I was passing through, in between an accident happened. Okay, and third, to express two or more actions going side by side in the past. John was reading, Sonu was reading. Writing. Okay, and third, it is used for indirect speech, for the reported speech. This is used. Okay, I am, for example, here a simple sentence is given, I am reading a book, and we have to change it to indirect. The direct speech is we have to change that sentence into an indirect speech. So how we will change it? I am reading a book will become, he said that he was. Okay, instead of am we will use was, he was. Okay, so the am becomes was. Okay, the form of the sentence is subject plus was were plus first form of the verb plus ing. First form of the verb is the present participle plus present participle. The first form of the verb plus ing is the present participle. Okay, if okay, you all know this. Let us see the table. When it comes, when the verb is with the singular, when the verb is with the singular, okay, we have to use was. Okay, I was, he, she, it was, I was, he, she, it was. Okay, but with you, we will always use were. Okay, with you, we will always use were. But in the singular person, it's always was. And the present participle is used, see, writing, ing, first form of the verb plus ing. Okay, and it doesn't change in the interrogative, neither it changes in the negative or interrogative. Okay, everything is same. Let's continue. Let's go with the perfect. In perfect, you know, in the present perfect we have used have and has. In the past perfect we will be using had, both for the singular and for the plural. Okay, and this tense is used to express an action in the past that was completed before another action, that was completed before another action also in the past. This my dear children, this tense is very important. And we have to really concentrate on this tense, the perfect past. Okay, the past perfect tense. So when two actions are happening, so we will use this for the action which happened before another action. Okay, for example, here the sentence, when I reached the station the train had left. See, we are using had here. The train had left before I reached the station. To express past in the past, see, same thing, he had left before I arrived. To express an action that took place at a point in the past, at some time in the past, at 9 o'clock the gates had closed. To express a past hope, desire or an intention, if you want to express it in the past, something of the past. I had not expected that result, some intent. Okay, an expectation. Okay, here had is used with all the persons. You can see had is used with all the person, but third form of the verb, that is the past participle. Let us look at the table here. Okay, had is used in all the persons, whether singular or they are plural. Okay, and also the form of the verb, the past participle is also used with all the persons. See, written. Okay, this we have to remember. Let's come to the past perfect continuous. Okay, and here, as we had used in the present, we used has or had. In the present we had used have or has, okay, plus ing, present participle. Okay, and here same we will be using, instead of have or has we will use had been. Instead of have or been or has been, we will be using had been. Okay, so this you should remember. So this is used for an action that had been continuous for a specific period of time in the past. Okay, for example, a person was standing for 10 minutes. Okay, so we'll say he had been standing for 10 minutes before the door was open. Also, it is used to talk about things that were going in the past when something else happened. Okay, that something else happened. Okay, for example, here he had been talking when the class was going on. So what he was doing when the class was going on, this person was talking, or this student was talking. So when something was happening and in between something else was happening. Okay, so that we will, for that we will use the perfect continuous tense. Form is we will use had been. Okay, let's continue. Here all the three persons are given, and also singular and plural are given. So we will use had been for all the persons. Had been will be used for all the persons. And present participle, we have to remember, the verb which is used here is present participle in all the form of the sentences. So God bless you children. If you have any doubt, just WhatsApp me your doubts, or you can ask your doubts in the Google Classroom. Signing off, Solomon Raj for you. God bless you.